Back in effect, do it like this or like that, and Silky Blaq. Shout out to my nephew Keely holding it down. You know what I'm saying? Oh, check me out. Make rap great again. Get yours, baby. I got all my paraphernalia up here, baby. I got everything, baby. I got the belt, I got the jacket, I got the shirt. Oh, and I talked about last week my vintage harmonica. You guys want to see this bad boy? Look at that. I don't even want to touch it. Look at that. Ain't it nice? No, I'm going to go ahead and bring it out. I'm going to bring it out. Bring them out. Bring them out. Look at that. Oh, wow. Yes, nice. Real nice. Oh, no, it's a harmonica. I wish y'all could see it. Close. I post a picture up there. I guess, I don't know. But yes, it's real nice. Hey, Ann. Fort Worth in the house. By the way, Vincent in the house. I see you, baby. Representing Vinton, baby. Hey, I'm drinking my smoothie. Because I'm not really on, I'm thinking 20 more pounds. One of my friends say that's way too much weight loss. So maybe 15. I don't know. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get small first. And I'm gonna, hit a note for me. I just seen that. Let me see. I ain't gonna play no vintage one. I play one of the other ones. Inglewood in the house. What's up, Ty? I ain't see that, man. Y'all jumped in early, baby. That's enough harmonica playing. Y'all gonna have to come to the concert for that. Matter of fact, I'm in the works right now, putting a blues band together, man. Because I got inspired by watching Luke Cage. Luke Cage has some cold blues players on there, boy. I said, man, them boys playing blues. No, but drinking a smoothie, trying to lose me some weight. Boy, I made some good smoothies. Me and my brother usually do a smoothie contest. I usually come out on top, but, you know, I'm talking about that right now. But, yeah, we're gonna air that. This one we're gonna go live. We're gonna chop it up, do it real live. My nephew Akili is gonna be one of the judges. You gonna judge this year or gonna let the young okay, so you gonna judge? Yeah. Slide down so I can see the incoming comments. That's it, it's going down now. Oh. Oh, we got a call coming in. Hold on, let me see who this is. No, they hung up. I don't know who it was, y'all. Y'all call back, whoever you was. Give me, Anita? What you said? Give you some Anita. Anita Baker? I don't know, man. Anita Baker. Sweet love. Don't get me on here clowning now, because you know I like to clown. I like to clown. But we got a lot going on. Hey, Camilla. Hey. It's your boy, Silky Blaq. Yeah, man, we got a lot going on. lot going on today. Matter of fact, want to mention that this is the day they killed Michael Jackson. 9 years ago they killed him. Hey, Andrew Mika. Yeah, they killed him 9 years ago today. And today, I think, man, I'm not sure. I hope this ain't real. It might be real, but another little news thing popped up on my phone. Joe Jackson died today. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Somebody look this up for me. Maybe my little news app thing is tripping or somebody typing in some fake news or something. But if that's so, that's crazy, man. Mike been hunting Joe all these years, man. 9 years Mike been hunting Joe. You know he's been hunting him with all the different type of mics. He's been hunting him as a the little young black Mike, the teenage Mike with the Jerry curl. He been hunting him as Thriller, Smooth Criminal. He just popped up in his dreams as all of them. Your bud is mine. Think of who else be you. I'm telling you the wrong thing. Steve, don't do. Steve, don't do. I told you not to be. And you don't want to become a man. A man. I know I can take it too far sometimes, but that's just what I do, man. What's on your shirt? What's on my shirt is Make Rap Great Again. It's online, man. I put it on. I'm selling these shirts, man. Get out there and buy these shirts. Oh, yeah, you can do them on. It's on Rage On. It's on my page. But I'll send you one. I'll send you a link. Yep, Mike got it. Mike turned into the Thriller on you. Know the That's why they ain't letting nobody in the hospital room. They ain't let nobody in the hospital room with Joe. He was saying the only person that can come in there is like all y'all handlers. Midwives or whatever that they be having in the hospice people. But I think it's true, man. Y'all check it out for me. Joe Jackson checked out today on the celebration death day of Micheal Jackson. Mike say, man, I can't have shit by myself. Joe died on this boy's death day? Dang, Joe. But shout out to Joe Jackson. What a wonderful man. Raised a whole bunch of wonderful kids, man. And made billions. Almost billions of dollars off of them kids. Well, he didn't make it off of kids. He made them kids make that much money. That was good. Good job, Joe. But, yeah, y'all call in and talk to him. We got a lot talking about. Like I said, there'll be a whole bunch of different news out there. So if I miss something, call me, let me know. Yeah, I did forget your name a little bit. I'm sorry, but it's right there. You got all that other stuff on there. I don't know what your name is. Quit putting all that extra stuff on there. But I'm going to get into these stories, man. Before I get into the little stories, the number to call in is 713-714-7670. Y'all call in and talk to me, man. This is the show Talk Up. I'm Silky Blaq. But before I want to get into the stories, I want to talk about, man, I seen a video. A dude was charging his phone, right? Check this out. Dude was charging his phone. His phone was in his pocket. The phone caught on fire. It's doing something. The phone caught on fire. This dude burst into flames like boom. his clothes on fire, his pants on fire. Now he's walking around, they beating him with shirts and stuff, but they not hitting him hard enough, so the shirts they beating him with, the shirts catch on fire. I'm like, dude, stop, drop, and roll. Stop, drop, and roll. He's still walking around, he's burning, now his flesh burning and stuff, his hair on fire. This dude is still walking. I don't know how it is to be on fire or what your mind going through, but he obviously wasn't paying attention to school whenever they firemen came to school and taught him how to, if you ever catch on fire, stop, drop, and roll. And they make the whole class. Now you say it, kids. Stop, drop, and roll. Yes, you stop, drop, and roll. I don't know what was going through this dude's mind, but he did not stop, drop, and roll, and it probably wouldn't have got that bad if he would have. See, that's what it is, kids. If you don't pay attention to class in school, you'll never learn that. You never know how to stop, drop, and roll. Just something that easy could have saved his life. It at least saved his half. He probably still living, but all his hair burned off. Gone. And it looked like he had that moose relaxer activated in there too. That ain't nothing but fire. What I'm trying to say? That ain't nothing but flammable. That ain't nothing but food for the fire right there. So, if you ever catch on fire, stop, drop, and roll. And if you don't understand fire, if you ever catch on fire, stop, drop, and roll. Could help you out a whole bunch, man. I'm telling you. Just a little helpful tip. Let me show talk up that. See, I got my little banner back here. Look nice, y'all. Tell me it look nice, y'all. Give me a thumbs up if it look nice, man. I'm trying to make it look nice around here. Hey, got my little lights going. Got the little banner going. Got my little shirts. Got my pins and everything. That boy's on fire. That boy is on fire. Did y'all see that? Did you see it? That was ridiculous, man. I'm like, oh my God. People screaming, ain't nobody even tackled him. All they had to do is pretty much probably tackle him and lay on him or something. They wouldn't have been on fire as much as he was, unless they probably say he was charging his phone, but that didn't look like just some phone, because his shirt was like blazing. He was like a ball of fire. What's up, Jeremiah? LaPortia? What's going on, baby girl? Vinton, Louisiana, I ain't gonna say just Vinton, because I don't know where she at. Where you at, LaPortia? Louisiana in the house, Port Arthur in the house. So, we know it's Michael Jackson death day today, so I've been listening to Mike all day. And rest in peace, Mike. Rest in peace, bud. Got my smoothie. Oh. First I want to talk about, and I want to know, what y'all think about this. The lady called the cops on the little girl for selling bottles of water in front of her house. Now, we kind of talked about this before. It's too much of this going on, too. It's too much calling the cops for nothing. Let's start charging these people for these blank 911 calls. I think it should be done. Vote, give me a thumbs up if y'all vote with me. Vote for the charge them for the blank 911 calls. Cause somebody could have been getting a house robbed at that time. But they answering to a 911 call stopping a little girl from selling water on the corner? Come on, man. This is too much. It's too much. But now the lady's all embarrassed. There you go. I got a lot of people voting for that. I know that's right. A little girl in the corner selling water, talking about she don't have no permit. Then the lady that did it is talking about, I was receiving so many death threats and it was just horrible and this and that and other. Yeah, but nobody thinks about how horrible it is if the cops come up and take all your merchandise and stuff you're trying to sell in the hot sun. That's all probably all the money they're getting if they're outside trying to sell some water. That's right, Ann. Give it up for Ann, y'all. She got emojis. She got the yes. Go ahead, Kara. But think about how bad it is if the cops come take them people water or whatever. That's the only money they making in the whole week. They probably selling a bottle of water for maybe $1. You got 24 in there. That's $24, and plus the tips or whatever. But still, let the kids sell that water. What's up, D-Rail? Where you at, baby? D-Rail, cutting up out there, boy. How you been, man? But yeah, man. Don't do that, people. White folks. Permit Patty. Barbecue Becky. Please stop. Don't have no more. That's good. People death threatening y'all and going on. That don't make no sense. Then after she talking about, yeah, because I've been receiving so many death threats and this and that and the other. And I should have just took a walk. Exactly. That's exactly what you should have did. Talking about they was yelling too much, talking about water for sale. Now mind you, they're across the highway from a baseball stadium. You know how much yelling and stuff going on over there. What's up, Wani? What's up, Shanika? Tracam? Everybody on here. How y'all doing? How you doing? But yeah, that's enough about Permit Patty. Your girl, Sarah Sanders. I know y'all heard about this. Sarah Huckabee Sanders. Huckabee. Went to some restaurant and the people knew who she was. So they refused to serve her. They refused service on her. And she's all upset and saying, oh yeah, well, they refused to serve me because they knew who I was and they knew what party I was with, and that's not fair. Oh, maybe they should have probably got a hot seat for her at Waffle House. Maybe you should go take your Huckabee-O to the Waffle House. They probably got all you can eat over there, baby. You probably get special treatment at the Waffle House. How you think you feel when we go somewhere to try to get something to eat and get refused service? Houston restaurant in Atlanta, IHOP, Waffle House. The list goes on and on and on and on. We always getting refused service, and it don't matter what party we with. It don't matter. What party we with? Hey Tina. What did I say? You know they come up. I don't know what to say. What is that? Keep it helping out. But yeah, they getting kicked out of restaurants now, and it hurts, don't it? It hurts. Oh, they're not serving us. Somebody help me. They're not serving us. That's good. Don't serve them nothing. They got all the food they can stand at the Waffle House. You know what I'm saying? They got the doors wide open for you. You know they come up athletic, but now they coming up all unfaithful and dacked on one. I don't know what to say. Help me out, Ann. So look over there and type that again, shit. But what's up, Jeffrey? Laura? Yeah. They getting over everywhere. So when a little stuff happen again like that, it's outrageous. It's outrageous. It's unheard of. But when it happened to us, I'm gonna get over it. Come on, it's just somebody was having a bad day. They need security at the Waffle House. Yeah, they do. For the people that be fighting up there, I seen a fight on Waffle House, but they always go up there drunk, just pretty much getting ready to eat and try to get rid of that alcohol. Put some waffles in their stomach, put something on top of that alcohol, and they go up there drunk and cussing and fighting. And sometimes they ain't getting their food fast enough. So whenever they go, they mad and get the cussing and fight and all that stuff. And you know. But I don't know. I don't wanna go. I'm not ever going to the Waffle House again. Never. I'm boycotting right now. Waffle House is on boycott. I'm boycotting Waffle House. No more waffles. I'm gonna go to IHOB. Go to IHOB and give me a burger waffle. You know that it's the house of International House of Burgers now, which is ridiculous. Speaking of burgers, they had a girl at Raising Cane. That's why you gotta pray over your food before you eat it. No matter where it's from. They had a girl at Raising Cane who got fired. She was stirring the tea with her arm. Her little nasty arm. Stuck it in the pitcher and was stirring the tea, laughing and joking like that's funny. That ain't funny. That's nasty. Oh yeah, they fired her. Ain't no telling how, if y'all drink tea from Raising Cane, ain't no telling how many arm bugs you got from drinking that hot, nasty arm tea. She got cuticle tipping, she got fingernails, stuff on the fingernails. She ain't had no gloves and nothing. She was just stirring up in there. Yeah, they got chicken waffles. She got stirring up there, probably just came out the bathroom, half washed her hands, digging in the nose, scratching her head, butt, legs, underarm, thighs, chin, nose, all that was under them nails, boy. And she stirring y'all tea up with that? You gotta get everything bottled now. Y'all can be going up in there drinking no tea out the, yes, nasty. Nasty. That make me feel some type of way. Make me feel some type of way. Yeah, that's crazy, man. People out here losing it, man. Y'all keep it together, don't lose it. It's easy to lose it. It's hard to keep it together. When you do stuff that's hard like that, that's a challenge and it strengthens you. Whatever don't kill you makes you stronger. I got a lot of little quotes for y'all today. So, Raising Cane's, watch them. Nasty people working Raising Cane's and Waffle House and IHOP and Houston's restaurant. Watch them. Watch your teeth. Be like this. You ever did this and ate something and you be like, and you think it's a living or something? So you grab it and you be like this. You ever did that part? The longer you come out, the gaggier it gets. You like, Yeah, make you sick. Yeah, I'm holding down by myself. Y'all call in and talk to me, man. The number is 713-714-7670. You can call in. You can holler at your boy, Silky Blaq. If you don't have nothing on the story, you can be like, what's up, Blaq? I'd be like, what's up? Be like, what's up? Be like, man, you got it. Like, cool. So, next story we got. And this might be the last one. Man, I'm by myself tonight. might cut it short. But I do need y'all to call in on this. They have come up with a abusing players and athletes, our football players, track, golf, and comedians. But now the athletes are married. Comics are old, and Dak don't want their ass, but so now they are using anything necessary to come up with. What you talking about, Ann? On the just the police or everybody? Let me know. Yeah, on the football. Oh yeah. They doing all this stuff. They doing, it's so much underhanded stuff that's going on now, especially with the football players. Them boys be out there getting concussions and medical conditions, knee injuries, hip, and once they out the league, they don't want to take care of them no more. They just throw them out like trash, especially in football. I think the basketball players get taken care of more than the football players, but them football players, they be going through it. And it's like man-to-man contact out there. Imagine a man 250, 300 pounds running to a guy that's 145 pounds, fast as he could, smashing into him. Something, if you don't get hurt right away, something's gonna hurt you later. And then that's not just one hit. That's over and over and over and over and over. Oh, something happened. I don't know what that was. But, I got a little message. What's up, Royce? Yeah, they got to come up with other stuff to try to get us now. You're exactly right. That's exactly right. But I need y'all to call in and talk to me on this one before I get on it. And I know y'all gonna wanna talk about this. Call me, 713-714-7670. Now, I seen a video to where, they was taking a baby to get Christian. And it was a mama, the daddy, and I got an auntie or something standing up there with the baby. And the priest, it looked like a little priest came out, too old to be still priesting on people. So he came out and the little baby was like, yeah, get me away from this creepy looking man, whatever. So by this time, you know, the baby cutting up and the priest grabbed the baby head. Like, okay, calm down, baby. I got you. You know, whatever. So the baby's like, oh, no, he got me. Let me go. He got me. I'm itching. The spirit has got me. Hold on. We got a call coming in. Hold on.
Call from.
Hey, you on live with Silky Blaq? This is Talk Up. Where you calling from? What's your name?
Yes.
Who this?
Hello?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Here, what's up, B?
Who this is?
This Ann.
Hey, Ann. How you doing? You on the phone live, baby, with Silky Blaq on Talk Up.
This Ann.
How you been?
I'm Ben and Victorian.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm calling in.
You hear me good or no?
It's Ann Victorian.
No, do you hear me?
Hey.
You gotta listen to the phone. You can't listen to the computer.
Huh?
You gotta listen on the phone. Hello?
Yes.
You gotta listen from your phone. The computer got a delay on it.
Okay, I'm gonna take it off.
Okay.
Okay, I sound better. Yeah, what I was talking about, I said, about the lady that police on their girl. Uh-huh. I said they mad because they ain't got no athletes no more.
Oh.
Yeah, you know, that was their piggy bag. You know, all them athletes and everything.
Oh, you
I
right.
I said, that ain't food. That fresh guy ain't fooling with them no more. He ain't got time for it. He been educated.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
And so they upset.
I said, so they find any means necessary to try to come up.
Yeah. And now it's like
they
mad about everything, and it's a shame because y'all got everything. What you mad about?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? It's like it
no. You know what? We got everything.
Okay.
They thought they had everything, but see, money is a rule out either. That money don't go too far.
You better talk to them, girl.
See, they mom and dad is mad. Mm-hmm. They ain't got nobody to leave nothing to.
Exactly.
Yeah. Not no legacy.
But you know what? I think this is why all them little kids, because it's something behind all these little kids coming up missing and adopting these kids and they coming up missing. I think it's some way they taking them organs and prolonging they. I don't know. I've been hearing stuff and reading little different articles and stuff about harvesting organs and stuff. And like that guy Rothschild, he done had so many transplants on his body. He probably like I think he died now. But what's up, Zach?
Because he was too fake.
Yeah, he had about 500-600 transplants. He was getting lungs and kidneys from everybody. He probably like a 14-year-old kid.
And you see what that was about, huh? Mm-hmm. Money.
Trying to go to the grave with. Ain't never seen a U-Haul behind no hearse.
Then they want to have a funeral. Just don't donate and have your ashes.
Yeah.
Take it to the ass.
Okay. Take it to the ass.
Yeah. Oh, what's up, dude? Why you here tonight?
Man, people, see, I'm on this side of town, and when people on the other side of town, now I'm supposed to be having a lot of people here next week.
But you act like the people, what side of town you on?
Oh, I'm in the middle. I'm in Third Ward.
He's down in Third Ward.
But my homeboy, Zach, is he's on the north side, and he got to drive a lot of long ways. Darrell, I don't know where Darrell is. Now, but I got some other ladies coming next week. And, because everybody are out of town doing their little vacation for the summer thing. But,
you need to get on there. I was like, that beef kitchen.
Yeah.
You
need
a beef kitchen down there.
Yeah, I don't know. I need to call, I need to put on here.
Well,
yeah.
You know, there's a lot of people down there. What's her name? Desiree?
She here too?
And Zeno, daughter. Destiny. I'm sorry, I said Desiree. Destiny.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Destiny Rose.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. You know, I try to tune in whenever I can.
I know, that's right. I appreciate it.
Hey, Ben.
Yeah, I sure appreciate it.
Yeah. You know, we got to support each other.
Okay.
I ain't got nothing coming up, so I'm going to support you.
Well, thank you, baby.
Mm-hmm.
All right, then.
Yep. Yeah. I ain't going to hold your line.
All right, stay on here and watching.
I'm going to keep watching.
Yes, ma'am. All right.
All right. Much love.
Be good.
You too.
All right, bye-bye. Yeah, that's my homegirl, Ann, calling in, talking to me. I appreciate it, Ann. Ann Victoria. We go way back. I think last time I seen her, I was 14, 15. That was a long time ago. But, what I was saying, so the priest had the little boy, and the boy was cutting up like, yeah, I don't want to be here, let me go. The priest smacked the boy in the face. He smacked this kid in the mouth, man. And the daddy, like, he's standing back like, oh, it took him maybe 12, 13 seconds to react. Man, I'd have been all on, I don't care what I was or who I was with. You standing there with your mouth open, you know what he did. You heard him smack him in the face, and I would smack him in his old face just as hard as he smacked my baby, or harder. I don't know how y'all feel about that. Call in, let me know how you feel about that. I obviously feel some type of way. I got really loud about it. So call me and tell me what you think about it and how y'all would have handled that situation. But that was horrible, man. This kid was maybe one, maybe a year old, and this man was 101 years old, and popped this kid in the mouth because he was flipping out. That ain't your job to be smacking that kid in the mouth. I don't know how they used to do it way back in his days like that, but not now. Because that would have been fine. And then when the daddy did try to take him away, what's up, B-Yank? When, Cynthia on here, Zach, when the daddy did try to take the boy away from him, he held on to his head. The old man was holding on to his head. Like, man, this dude is crazy. I'd have knocked the devil out of him right there. I'd have hit him so hard in his chin, he'd have lost some of his baby teeth. We would have been fighting up there. That would have been a more interesting video if I was in there, I'll tell you that. It's crazy. Y'all tell me what y'all think about that, man. That was horrible. Matter of fact, any one of my stories, Sarah Sanders, Michael Jackson, Daddy, Michael Jackson, the Little Dirty Girl, the Raising King, all of that. Ain't nothing much, y'all, but yeah, I'm trying to get it going. I got banners and stuff up. Got my headphones. Got a Keely in the house. Holding it down with his Uncle Blaq. And that's a fact. I got a couple more shows, y'all, and I might be hitting the road. I might be going back on the road. No telling. See how it go out in the streets. What's up, Bettina? What's up, Laura? Y'all call in. What y'all think about that priest? Did you see it? If you didn't see it, I can act it out for you. So a little baby crying. Just the priest's hands. The priest grabbed his head like this. So of course, the baby's like, get your hands off me, your hands stink. So the baby trying to get away, look like he's holding the baby nose. Thing, look like you're holding the baby's nose when the baby trying to get away. And all you hear is like, pow, you seen his face, you seen the priest's face get like mean. Like something else was in there. So the priest smacked the baby in the face and he made he smacked the baby in the face, pow. So the baby was like, wow. And the dad was like, huh. Stood there for maybe 15 seconds, way too long. I don't know if they fired him. They was trying to pull the baby away from him. But he didn't let go. So they cut the camera off. I don't know if they fired him or not, but they need to. I hope so. That was bad news right there, boy. Couldn't have been, he picked the right family to be smacking their baby in the mouth. Because he would have hit one of them butt wines like that. It would have been all up and down. We'd have all jumped up. We'd have been like, we didn't have a whole family. What's up, Lamar? We didn't have a whole family fight like that before, because we get down on family fight. We used to fight at family reunions and everything. Well, we weren't fighting each other, we was fighting other people that was on the other side of the park. But, yeah, man. What's up, Amar? When you coming to town, baby? Yeah, Lord, I might go back on the road. I don't know. What? Ain't no telling. That's right, Jimmy. We would've got with it, baby. We would've been, they would've still been rolling cameras up in there. Talking about, oh, he shouldn't have never did that. Get him, Dennis! We would've been all up on him up in there, boy. Team, Law. But I had a good week. Yeah, I make these little shirts, y'all. Mario, you coming back in July? You like these? This jacket, this shirt? This little banner right here? It's nice, man. You can go on, I think it's Rage On. It's a little iPhone app. So you guys out there without iPhones, y'all might not be able to get it, you know what I'm saying? Nah, but it's probably on everybody's phone, you can get it. I've been seeing a bunch of people on there, you're going it's pretty cool, you can make your own little shirts, make your own designs or whatever. Pretty cool. So yeah, go on there and get one of my little shirts. I made a couple of them, I put them on Facebook. Matter of fact, y'all can go to my page, check it out, scroll down, or type in Rage On, or Silky Blaq Rage On, or whatever like that, and they'll all pop up, R-A-G-E-O-N, Rage On. So I put together a little, couple of little designs, and they look nice, man. Good quality shirts, it's probably never wash off, never fade. So, get one. Get those shirts, man. Wear it. Wear that shirt. Talk up. Let it do. Never know what it's called. Might be the only one. Might be the first one with one of them shirts, baby. Oh, Sharon said my mom would have ripped his arm off and beat him with it. I know that's right. Did y'all see that? That was ridiculous, man. What would possess you to do that? Let me say that again. What would possess you to do that? The devil, huh? Right there, and I seen it come out right in his face. The way he looked. You seen it, Keith? It's horrible, scary. Actually, it was. The way he looked at the kid when he did it and everything. It was like a, you ever seen that movie The Rite? Where the actual priest was the demon? Ooh. Man, y'all look that movie up. I don't know if it's on Netflix or what. I know a lot of people got fire sticks. It's called The Rite. I think it's R-I-T-E. Maybe. I think his name was Reverend Wright. So. Yeah. What was that? Looking for an excellent DJ and a lead guitar player. But you need a... I'm an excellent DJ, baby girl. You know that. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if you lead guitar player. I don't know a guitar player. But I'm looking for a guitar player. Somebody put me together a band, baby. Stan is the man with the rock, rock, rock. I got a whole bunch of harmonicas. I don't know if y'all seen it yet. But I just pulled out my vintage harmonica. This thing is probably about 200-300 years old. Cause you can see the carvings on there. It's like the original carvings on it. I'm not gonna play it. I'm not gonna touch it. This thing is the real deal. Maybe one of the first ever made. It's in the original packaging. It's in good condition. I wouldn't say mint condition is in good condition, but it's been stored away pretty good. made by Horner from Germany. It's the Echo. You see if I got a year on it. I'm looking for a year. Year on here. 1819. And they was making harmonicas? All of this is wood. You remember I was telling you all my other one was plastic? All this is wood. And you don't want to get that too waterlogged and mess that up because it won't play right. So I don't even want to blow on it. It got double sides, you can blow on either side. This one, these you only can blow on. Oh, you can suck on the other side. Oh, this side is G. And this side is C. Wow, it's a C and G harmonica at the same time. But you just have to flip it. So you got two harmonicas in one. And this one is just a C. And you're going to trade one side. Very interesting. But I'm going to keep it in this pack. And it ain't going nowhere. 1819 vintage harmonica, guys. Right here. In the case. I got it if you want it. It got a pretty price on this one. It's got a pretty price on it. The lady that gave it to me was very nice and soft spoken, and she said she didn't want to give it to nobody because she didn't know anybody that knew how to play the harmonica. When she gave it to me, she said, "I've been having this for a long time." I guess she got it from somebody, because she's a musical lady. Or maybe she got it from somebody that was in a band. I don't know. Maybe I need to go back over there and find out the history on this thing. It might be worth more than what I think it's worth. That's weird. And she let me have it. She said, "I never heard nobody play like that before, baby." I got a lot of them things in the house. But she had some of these, and she gave me this. Nice. Real nice. But I guess that's it, y'all. That's it, Akeem? What you think? What's up, Zach in the Cadillac? Bring it on back. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Now Zach a real busy man. I know all my people is. They be taking care of business. I understand. But I'm gonna keep it going like this. This is Micheal Silky Blaq. Oh Lord, you must have came on here late. She said play a little bit for me. See this one This is a chromatic harmonica. This the one Carl Thomas wanted, and I didn't know. He didn't know what he wanted, and I didn't know what he wanted. But when I figured it out, it was this one. Got a Silky Blaq harmonica 101. All right, y'all. I'm gonna put this on YouTube. Make sure you go to Silky Blaq on Facebook.
And order these shirts, man. Get your shirt, get your jacket, get your belt, get your something. You know what I'm saying?
But thank y'all for watching. And see y'all next week. Maybe 6, 7, 8 people. I don't know.
Y'all keep saying play something. Y'all watching or is this on delay or something? Everybody keeps saying play something.
I don't have nothing to play. Talk up. I'm Silky Blaq. And we are. Hold on, let me get my, hold up. Yeah.